Good morning, student. This is teacher Sidra from the Wave Private School. Today we have a new lesson, and in this lesson we will discuss about the lenses. Physics, this is grade 10, unit 30, and the course book page 191. What are lenses? We are all familiar with lenses in everyday life, in spectacles and cameras. There are two types of lenses according to their effect: converging lens and diverging lens. Converging lenses are fatter in the middle than at the edges. This is converging lens, that is fatter in the middle than at the edges. Diverging lenses are thinner in the middle than at the edges. This is diverging lens, that is thinner in the middle than at the edges, that are fatter. Figure shows how a converging lens focuses the parallel rays of sun. In this figure, as you can see, this is converging lens, where this is principal axis, and converging lens, this lens focuses the parallel rays. These rays are parallel to the principal axis, and this lens focuses the parallel rays of sun. On one side of lens, rays are parallel to the axis of the lens. This side, rays are parallel to the axis. After they pass through the lens, they converge on a single point called principal focus. When they pass through the lens, they converge, and at one point, this point is called principal focus. When they pass through the lens, they converge on a single point called principal focus. So we can say that this point is principal focus, where all the lines converge together. After they passing through principal focus, they spread out again. As you can see in this fig, when they converge at one point, that is principal focus, after they pass through the principal focus, they spread out again. As you can see, they are spreading. So converging lens is so called because it makes parallel rays of light converge. Why it is called converging lens? Because this lens makes them to converge at one point, to meet at one point. So we can say it is called converging, like rays meet at one point after passing through the lens. The principal focus is the point where the rays are concentrated together. So here in this fig, this point is called principal focus. And what is principal focus? It is the point where rays are concentrated together. Now we will see the effect of converging lens. A fat lens has a shorter wavelength than thin lens. A converging lens can be used in reverse to produce a parallel rays. This is the process, that is converse process. A converging lens can be used in reverse to produce a parallel rays. A source is now placed at the principal focus. Here, as you can see in this fig, this is the principal focus, where source like bulb, this bulb is a source. This is placed at the principal focus. As they pass through the lens, rays are bent. As these rays pass through the lens, this is lens, as they pass through the lens, they bend. They become parallel. So they become parallel beam as shown in fig. When these rays coming from the source and passing through the lens, they bend and become parallel to the beam as shown in the fig. These are parallel rays after passing through the convex lens or converging lens. Lenses work by refracting light. It works on the principle of refraction, and you know this thing, that what is refraction? Refraction is the process in which when light enters from one medium to another medium, it changes its direction. So same phenomena occurs here when it changes its material, like from air to glass, it changes its direction. So lenses work by refracting light. Here refraction occurs. When ray strikes the surface of lens, it is refracted towards the normal. When it leaves the glass of lens, it bends away from normal. This is refraction of light. And lenses work on this phenomena. Lenses work on this phenomena of refraction. Here we will see how a real image is formed. Figure shows an experiment in which an image of light bulb is formed by a converging lens. Here, in this experiment, we will see how converging lens helps us. Converging lens makes an image by focusing an image of a light bulb onto a piece of white paper. As you can see, this is converging lens. This is source, or we can say a light bulb. And the converging lens makes an image of this light bulb onto a screen. This is converging lens, this is source, and this is screen. And screen, there in which here we will use the paper that acts as a screen. The paper acts as a screen to catch the image. So this paper acts as a screen that catches the image. In experiment, the image is inverted upside down. As you can see here, image is inverted like upside down. Reduced, smaller than the object. This is object and this is image. And image is reduced like smaller than the object. Nearer to the lens than the object. If you see the distance between them, the object has larger distance and the image has smaller distance. So we can say that smaller than object, reduced. Nearer to the lens than the object, and it is real. We say that image is real because light really falls on the screen to make image. If light appeared coming from image, then we will say image is virtual. Clear now? It means that now light is coming directly. If light feels like it coming from the image, then we can say the image is virtual. Now it is real because light directly falls on the screen. Now we will see, we will explain it by a ray diagram. The steps needed to draw an accurate diagram are listed below. Draw the lens with a horizontal axis through the middle of it. As you can see here, this is converging lens, and draw the lens with the horizontal axis. This line is called axis, horizontal axis, and this is middle of the lens. Draw it middle of the lens. Mark the position of the principal focus on either side of at equal distances from the lens. Position of principal focus, as you can see here, this is principal focus, and both are at equal distance from the lens. Then mark the position of object O and arrow standing on the axis. This is called position of object O, and mark it by standing an arrow on the x-axis. Draw ray 1, a straight line from the top of the arrow. This ray is called ray 1. Draw ray 1 from the top of the arrow and passing through the middle of the lens. Draw ray 1, straight line from the top of the arrow and passing through the middle of the lens. This is the middle point of the lens. So start from the top of the arrow and pass through the middle of the lens. Draw ray 2 from the top of the arrow parallel to the axis. Come here. As you can see, this is axis or principal focus, we can say here. Draw ray 2 from the top of the arrow parallel to the axis. This is axis. So ray 2 start from the top of the arrow and parallel to the axis. As it passes through the lens, it is deflected down through the principal focus. As it passes through the lens, it is deflected down. As you can see here, as it passes through the lens, it is deflected down here in this way, and passes through the principal focus. This point is called principal focus, so it passes through the principal focus. Look at the point where the two rays cross. This is the position of top of image 1. This point where two rays cross each other, this point is called the position of image 1. I is represented by image 1. Here two rays cross each other and image is formed. With accurately drawn ray diagram, you see that image is real, inverted and reduced. Now let's proceed and see that how a magnifying glass works. A magnifying glass is a converging lens. Magnifying glass can help to magnify print for someone with poor eyesight. The object viewed by magnifying glass is closer to the lens than principal focus. See, in this picture, object is nearer to the converging lens than to the principal focus. In the figure, we can see that ray 1 is undeflected as it passes through the center of the lens. This is ray 1. It is undeflected as it passes through the center of the lens. Ray 2 starts off parallel to the axis. Ray 2, same happens as we have discussed in the last slide. Ray 2 starts from the top of the arrow and it is parallel to the axis and is deflected by the lens so that it passes through the principal focus. And after deflection, it passes through the principal focus. Ray 1 and ray 2 do not cross over each other. See here, ray 1 and ray 2 do not cross each other, because they are diverging after they pass through the lens. Diverging means they are spreading apart after they pass through the lens. However, if we extend the ray backward as shown by dashed lines, we see that both appear to be coming from a point behind the object. This is the position of image 1. See here, if we extend these two rays by dash point, we can say these are extended and meet at one point, and this point is called position of image 1. Image produced by magnifying glass are upright, means right way, not inverted. As we have seen in the last slide, the image is downward, but here image is right way, like upside. Magnified bigger than the object, further from the lens than the object. See here, object is nearer, but image is further apart from the lens. So, image is further from the lens than the object. Virtual, not real. So, if you read a book using a magnifying glass, image is behind the page that you are reading. See here, this is a magnifying glass and it helps you to read a topic very clearly if you have a poor eyesight. Thank you.